949 broadcasting live from the bunker. Today I want to talk about corporations, and not corporations in the normal sense. I'm talking about government-ran corporations, which is basically your state, city, and local governments, and police departments, and no doubt, even the Superior Court of Arizona is a corporation. How about the Department of Corrections? Corporation. Let's talk about the United States of America. Yes, it's a corporation too. But if you go look for it, you don't look for it in Washington, D.C. You go look for it in Colorado. Today we're going to talk about Dun & Bradstreet. Dun & Bradstreet is DNB.com. It's a global information source for people that want to check up on corporations all over the world. Basically, you can type in the corporation, you can find out their credit history, their debt ratios, and everything like that. It's similar to the credit files that TransUnion has on individuals, but this is only for corporations. We're going to type in Scottsdale Police Department into Dun & Bradstreet. If you look down, you'll see the city of Scottsdale. That says also traded as Scottsdale, the police department, the city of Scottsdale, the Tucson Police Department, the Mesa, Gilbert Police Department. You can go and type your own police department in. Department of Public Safety is a for-profit corporation. Now, I don't have a problem with corporations. What I have a problem with is government creating corporations to the detriment of the free market. And they often do this because they create monopolies. I've seen this up close and personal with the police unions expanding their power and revenue via using legislatures down at the state and local governments to create laws to force out the private security industry. For instance, public schools around here used to be able to hire private security guards. Not anymore. They're forced to by the government through the legislature to hire pirates. Now we have a $100,000 police Tahoe out in front of every school. First of all, what are corporations? How are they set up? Take for instance a city, a local city. Who is the CEO? The CEO would be the mayor. And then you have the board of directors, which are the city council. And then the board of directors answer to the shareholders. Well, a lot of people believe the shareholders are the people, which is totally false. That they're not the shareholders, because they definitely don't get a benefit or a dividend check back from the government. They may get some sorry services, if that's what you call a benefit, but I don't believe that that's a dividend check. So basically, who are the shareholders? I would say, who benefits directly off of it? Well, someone would say the employees. The employees benefit directly from the state by via a check. And who gives them that check? Investors make money off interest by the bonds that they give the city. So if you're a corporation, you run yourself into oblivion, which normal corporations go bankrupt. Well, not state governments, because they have the force of people with guns and badges. What they do is go rob from the people in order to fund and give back to investors. This whole situation is a reminder of a relationship between a gangster and his mob boss, i.e. investor. The gangster owes this debt to the mob boss, and guess what? He steals, maims, and does everything he can to pay that debt back to the mob boss. So what happens? You get fined, and all that money gets sent back to the shareholder, which is the investor. So basically, it's a big circle jerk with all these people, and you ain't invited to the jerk, and you're definitely getting some white stuff in your face. So who are some of the investors? That would be China, political friends. They're political friends. So they make money off the interest. So they're investing in the police departments, the cities. And so if you have a constant investor and you have to keep your AAA rating, guess what you do to get the money back to the investor? You get more and more violent. You get more and more sinister. You get more and more crazy in order to force people to give you money to get back to the investments, and all the city employees can make a ton of money. The average salary in Phoenix is $123,000 if you work for the city. That's including benefits and everything like that, which is, to me, the average salary is that much? I mean, that's crazy. I mean, imagine if all the employees working for McDonald's were making $123,000 a year. I mean, and then they were using the force of government for you to buy their hamburgers at $10 a whack. I mean, people would call that outrageous. Well, that's what you're getting right now with government. And who do corporations have loyalty to? Is it you? No, they don't have any loyalty to you. They have loyalty to their investors, which they take the investment from you by force. The other investors, they have to ask. They steal from you and give it back to the investor. This all boils down to, we have a major problem in this country. And if you think you're going to vote your freedom back, or you're going to vote these problems away, you haven't been paying attention for the last 100 years.